Hello again, everybody. Welcome to another exciting episode of Random Vlogging. So, first things first, sorry this is late. This week has been bad, to say the least. But I'm seeing my doctor on Monday? Yes, Monday. So hopefully that will help and I can figure out what I'm doing next. Other than that, I had an idea about what I wanted to talk about today, and I started doing research for it, and I realized that I might be biting off just a little bit more than I can chew. So I think I'm going to leave that specific subject for a later vlog when I can devote a little bit more time to it. Due to the fact that yesterday's vlog, or I guess Wednesday's vlog, was so long, I wanted something a little bit shorter. So today, I'm going to talk about my love of Dragon Age Inquisition and my hate of it as well. For those of you who don't know, one of the things I got for Christmas was a gift card for Amazon that I used to buy a few things, one of which was Dragon Age Inquisition for my PS3. Because I didn't think my computer could run Dragon Age Inquisition. And I tend to prefer console games because they tend to work better. They were designed for the console. They just tend to work. First things first, Dragon Age Inquisition is phenomenal. I have over 40 hours in it already. I've still just barely gotten through, I think, like 3 or 4 of the big story missions. The rest has just been me wandering around Thedas, just enamored with how much fun it is. Even just wandering around and like closing rifts and stuff like that is really enjoyable because the combat system is great. Just wandering around Ferelden or Lay is just a blast because the characters will talk to each other. And some of the interactions are hilarious. Sarah is definitely my favorite companion. But I like all of them. Like, everything is just so well designed. However, it was designed for next-generation consoles. So I was expecting, because I've been watching Sarah the Rebel play Dragon Age Inquisition on her stream, because it's a really fun game, and Sarah is awesome. So, I've seen what it looks like on a PS4 because she streams from a PS4, and it looks gorgeous. It looks so nice. So I'm like, yeah, I was not expecting that level of quality because, yeah, it's an older system. What I was kind of expecting, you know, lower graphical quality, stuff like that. What I wasn't expecting is it is massively glitchy. And it has really, really bad lag issues, which I was able to fix. They have these things where you can sign in to, I can't even remember what it's called, but it's an online thing that lets you update your world and save things, and it's kind of weird. And then you can also do things like there's an option to randomly send anonymous information to help blah, blah, and you know all that stuff. Before I turned that stuff off, in the middle of battle, I would get lag that would kill me because the game would freeze while I'm trying to fight, and then by the time it unfroze, I was dead. Because some of the bad guys, if you're not watching what you're doing, they can kill you in probably about 5 seconds because they'll just hit you like, I don't know, 3 or 4 times with really heavy hitting. And I'm a mage, so I'm already kind of squishy. So yeah, I got really annoyed with it. When I turned that stuff off, it got a lot better. I don't really have the lag so much, except when it's like saving, I have to kind of sit there and wait for it to finish saving before I do anything else. Otherwise it gets really, really laggy. But it crashes randomly. Like I've had, you know, right before a big boss battle or something, it will crash on me. And I'll have to start. Luckily, the game saves like every 2.5 seconds, which is really, really nice. So I don't think I've ever had to replay more than maybe about 10 or 15 minutes worth of content. But yeah, it was really, really annoying that the PS3 version has so many like massive issues. And it's not just like, oh, it just doesn't look very pretty. I could care less about graphics. I've been playing a bunch of 8-bit stuff recently that I think is amazing and awesome. So graphics are not that big a deal to me, and they never have been. I've actually had arguments with people that are like, oh man, the graphics sucks. I can't play it if the graphics are bad. It's like, well, then I don't agree with that. If the gameplay is good, it really doesn't matter what the graphics look like. That's why games like Chrono Trigger, or like I still play Legend of Dragoon. I downloaded it on my Vita, and I've been going through that campaign again. The graphics suck. They really do, compared to what we have now. Back then, they were groundbreaking. They were very, very good. It was a beautiful game. And I love it because it's a great game. The story's phenomenal. The gameplay is fun. Even just your regular old, you know, random battles, because the addition system is just a blast. So yeah, I really don't care that it doesn't look all that pretty. It is a little disappointing when I was expecting something a little bit closer to the PS4 graphics, because it's phenomenal on PS4. And instead, it looks like I'm fairly certain it would run better on my computer, which is like 6 years old at this point. Like, I've had it for a long time, and it was decent when I got it, but it was nowhere near, you know, spectacular. I mean, I think I got the whole thing for about $550 is how much I spent on it, because it was a refurb model. And I've slowly been adding, like, I added a video card. I'm going to be adding some memory to keep it current. But it's not an amazing thing. And I still think it could have played a little bit better on my computer than it does on my PS3, which is upsetting. But what are you going to do? It's still phenomenal. I'm still playing way too much of it. That's all for me this week. Yeah, follow me on Twitter, all the YouTube stuff that you're supposed to say, you know, get the game. It's phenomenal. If you have the choice between old console generation and new, definitely get the new. I cannot stress this enough. It is significantly better on the new consoles. And if your computer can run it, and all you have is all I've got is a PS3 and a computer, maybe go with the computer, because I don't, like I said, I'm not particularly fond of the console port of it. It's not quite the quality I was expecting. Still amazing, though. If all you have is a PS3 or an Xbox 360, still get it. It's phenomenal. It's wonderful. So anyway, yeah, that's all for me this week. I will see you guys on Tuesday for some Streamy Streams with TJ. Bye-bye.